we came up with the idea of PsyOps because basically we wanted to come up with something different and unique for the third-person action adventure genre. So we looked for something new and different, and we started to research military tactics and things that the military have used over the years. And as we started doing more research into different types of Psi powers, we found that there was a whole bunch of different powers that have been researched by governments around the world for decades now. And all these powers have actually been used in real military simulations around the world. So we took that and we just started digging deeper and deeper into the research of it. And it's actually pretty scary to find out all the things that are going on in the military. The more you look into this, the more you find. People are really doing some pretty in-depth research into telekinesis and even pyrokinesis and mind control and how the governments have used mind control in different warfare situations. We talked to a number of experts in the field too, and even brought some people in to talk to find out exactly how they've used these powers in the real world situations.
And then in addition, we also looked into some declassified government documents. The United States government and governments around the world have been supporting PsyOps programs for several decades.
It was really kind of amazing to find out that a lot of this really existed.
What the Psy powers really add to the game is some drama.
The Psy power experience in this game is different than any other game, and you can execute them in a level that you haven't been able to execute these types of powers before.
Telekinesis is the ability to lift objects or enemies and toss them around. With pyrokinesis, you can launch a wall of flames at your enemies or at other objects.
Come on, get out of my mind!
Mind control, being able to take over somebody else's body and control them to do almost anything that character can do. And then through mind control, you can use weapons that you don't have access to yourself. That's a huge gameplay strategy right there.
Mind drain is an essential Psy power. It allows you to rejuvenate your Psy energy and also allows you to blow up enemies' heads.
Or of you to see into the different realm and see things that you wouldn't normally be able to see, and then use those as clues, tips, a method to get by certain areas that you wouldn't normally be able to get by without that particular power.
Remote viewing is the ability to go out of body and look into areas you haven't been in, or slide through a door and look into a room where there's an ambush waiting for you, and then you can plan how to get through that ambush.
The Psy powers are always something I think that people think are cool, things that people would really love to be able to do if they could do it in real life.
Portraying the Psy powers in PsyOps was a particular challenge for the team. We went through a lot of iterations of different, special effects like the particle effects, the glows on objects. That in combination with the animations on the character as he throws something, as he lifts something up, as he goes into his remote view, all those different things combined is really what helps sell the different Psy powers.
We wanted them to be impressive, to jump off the screen.
And then we kind of took them and we kind of Hollywoodized them.
A lot of different movies were our influences for Psy powers in the game.
A lot of blockbuster American movies, just movies that would have an effect that you really noticed, like the kind of effects that happen at the end of a movie, something that really just stands out and goes, wow.
One of the first mandates was not to make it look like magic, to stay away from that, because it's very easy to make something like pyrokinesis look like a fireball that you might see in a fantasy game or something. And we wanted to do something that was a little more hard-edged, a little more supernatural. We actually set up environments that were built to what we thought the spec would be in the final game. We had characters that were about the right number of polygons so that we could actually move them around, show what they would look like interacting with particles, just to see what it would look like with the lighting techniques and the screen warping techniques. The 3D software that we use is extremely powerful and allows you to really get under the hood. The things that you see in the movie are implemented in a pre-rendered way very similar to the way they ended up being done in the engine. And I'm very pleased how close they still are in the final product to what we had originally.
My favorite Psy power in the game is probably TK, because it's probably just the most physics-based Psy power. I think it's the power that most shows off just how different games will be in the future.
Telekinesis we knew was going to be a huge power in the game. It was probably going to be the main non-weapon offensive power. So we went through a lot of iterations and processes to get that looking how we wanted it in 3D and to make it look like it would be as fun as we knew it was going to be.
The first thing that we did was we actually did a rendered mock-up, a movie that showed you using telekinesis in different ways and how we would want it to actually work. This allowed us to get things down like the camera paths, how it's going to follow you, how the actual lifting of an object goes, how we want it to react when you throw it to people. This gave us the basis of how we would take that and turn it into a real gameplay element.
The biggest challenge with telekinesis were the controls. How do you control something in the air? And then how do you move it around in 3D space? And then how do you throw it? How does that work?
And then once we've got that code in place, then we actually need to start having it, you know, affect the things in the world.
One of the neat things about telekinesis, in a way, and I shouldn't be saying this, is just how much you can almost break the game with it. There's just so much you can do with TK that it's really this awe-inspiring power. One of the things on telekinesis is the TK surfing that happened. A lot of people think we made a conscious decision that we want people to TK surf, and more it was just the power of the physics and the telekinesis that just let it happen. It's almost impossible to not TK surf.
Pretty shortly after that, we realized that the player is definitely going to want to be able to pick up enemies and throw them. So what we did is we took Havok's ragdoll system and we made it applicable to our characters. I went into the lead programmer's office and I found him throwing a ragdoll repeatedly against the wall and giggling to himself. Then we knew we had a good game.
The effects that you see when you're using TK, we have this kind of blue mist that sort of drips off of things and it feels very bright. It's got these light smears in it. And I think eventually we came up with something that doesn't feel at all magical, but it feels very strong, very powerful, and you feel very connected to it.
So pyrokinesis kind of surprised us because at first it was always viewed as being too powerful.
Visually, I think the most impressive side power is probably pyrokinesis.
Pyrokinesis was a fairly difficult power to imagine. We wanted it to feel like just a raw wave of heat energy, just ripping through things.
I love the effect on Nick's arm when he throws the fire.
And you're throwing a huge wave, and you know the lighting is affected in the scene.
It's just a great way of just dispatching enemies quickly.
The way we make fire in PsyOps is we displaying a particle system, which is basically a lot of small graphics repeated over and over again that move around in a cloud.
We're fortunate, we have a very powerful in-house particle tool that allows us to do things that I've never seen before in a game. It's just so powerful. Particles spawning other particles, all kinds of behaviors. It's allowed us to achieve not only a level of realism with our pyrotechnics and our explosions and our, you know, more realistic effects, but it's allowed us to do some very powerful looking psi effects.
I don't just believe that other governments have PsyOps programs like the United States. I know it. We've done a lot of research into it.
After reading all the materials and all the website stuff that I've found, it's quite clear that there is something going on.
A lot of the research behind PsyOps is all based on fact. I don't know if we're ever going to see somebody really light somebody on fire, lift them up, and shoot them. But I do think the Psy tactics are going to be a bigger thing in real military operations.
Yes, I'm sure that there are governments that have spent quite a bit of effort and money on developing Psy programs.
I mean, everything you read is like, it's there, but we can't admit that it's there. So you have to kind of believe that they exist a little bit out in the real world.
We've heard enough about the U.S. government having done it that anybody that hopes to be another world power would probably have to try doing it as well.
Hard concentration sometimes feels like you might be able to do physical things just by thinking hard enough about them.
Where is it at in terms of real life? I guess time will tell.
You want the truth or you want a good story?